Gold Digger doesn't care if you watch us look for gold in Adirondack Mt. Don't be lazy, hit that subscribe button. God wasn't lazy. When after he made heaven and earth, he made the universe. And he made man so good that a chiropractor can work on his back and it will lower his blood pressure. And if you're one of these people that takes medicine, it lowers your immune system. You can tell that because the medicine, you take this medicine, you can catch something bad. A chiropractor can work on that to get that fixed too. Well, here's the tools I'm going to use the rest of the years for digging gold in Adirondack Mountains. My Garrett ATX, a nice pick, and that's a 20-inch. I got these because it's a PI machine and pulse induction. And the pulse inductions they go down deeper into the ground. And the bigger the coil, the deeper it goes. I think this is what they call a double D thing. There's also some stuff. And this coil here is a mono or something like that. They're not so sensitive and they no discrimination on iron, I guess. And this in here you have discrimination on iron. And as I know, they say all over the internet, and I'll say gold stays on the bedrock. Well, I don't know about that. For the simple reason, a long time ago, they had old timers, the first gold rush. They used to find gold out west, and they dug deep ditches to find the gold. I don't know how they find the gold in deep ditches. But anyways, now when they look for them, they say, oh, I'm going to go where they found the gold a long time ago, and there's deep ditches and big rocks piled up. And now they find gold where the rocks and dirt are piled up. But how'd they get there? Did the old timers, so they couldn't went down too far because the old timers threw it up and they didn't like it and they still find it. But the original couldn't have been all the way down to the bottom all over. So I'm saying maybe the gold is not all the way down. I just have to find out. Everybody says it from the beginning. And I got this late last fall. I have to learn how to use it. How to use it from the beginning to end, I guess. That's what I'm going to be doing today, learning how to use it. Must be a skunk was here last night. I covered this all up so it'd be normal. Okay. And over there, they dug that up too, where it had that iron thing. So I'm going to put it. Where you see the bigness. They say it somewhere about right in here. That's the highest it is, so it's right. More or less in non-motion mode, it'll give you the biggest, strongest signal. This is all dug up too. Must be a skunk was here last night. This, I covered this all up so it'd be normal. Okay. And over there, they dug that up too, where it had that iron thing. So I'm gonna put it where you see the bigness. They say it somewhere about right in here. That's the highest it is, so it's right. It's more or less in non-motion mode, it'll give you the biggest, strongest signal. This is all dug up too. We're going to try iron check. Says there's no iron. Thank you. slow motion, so the definitely, they gotta come here and check this out. Definitely, I gotta learn more about this. Get the dirt farther away. A little signal's got me mixed up. definitely I gotta learn more. How do I? It said it's iron check here. It says locating. My machine is picking up. Oh, that must be my low battery sound. Well, I'll let you know what it is. I have to put in an advertisement now for the Adirondack Mountains. My name is Gareth Tooley. I'm the CEO of 22nd Century New Technologies Company, Incorporated. I got this name a long time ago because I looked at very small stocks. One of these stocks made scrubbers for CO2 scrubbers for electric coal burning smokestacks. These scrubbers took out CO2. This is what Biden is worried about. Everybody knows that they made fire extinguishers from CO2 because to would go down to the ground and stay there and smother the fires. And a long time ago, there was a guy that had tuberculosis. He went up to the Adirondack Mountains. And 3 weeks, he was cured. In that 3 weeks, when he went there, he thought he was going to die. So he made a tuberculosis hospital where they fixed tuberculosis. That's how clean the air is up in the Adirondack Mountains. And when it gets 20 to 30 degrees outside, the cold weather takes all this CO2 right down to the ground. Captain Joe says, when you look up the air and see the jets going by, and you see fumes behind it, that's just like your breath when you're outside cleaning your windshield wipers. So you can think of Al Gore when he's flying around in his jet. He's helping the planet because all that jet fumes, CO2, is going down to the ground and into the ocean. And he's saving the seaweeds to be grown. So he's saving the planet.
Take your best, Mr. Chairman. Panelists, let me just go right down the line real fast. What percent of our atmosphere is CO2? Take your best guess. You don't have to be accurate. All down the line.
Repeat that question.
What percent of our atmosphere is CO2, carbon dioxide? Wild guess, it's okay.
I'll buy 5%.
Right.
I'll just follow you.
We'll go 7.
I'll see there 5 and suggest that we know that transportation causes 49% of CO2, so that's why we're all working on energy transition.
All right. So what number do you think it is?
5.
Right. What about you? I didn't hear you, Mr. Dreher.
7.
7. Do you have one, Mr. Boyd?
So we got a 5-7.
Price is Right.
8. I'm going to take the high end.
All right. Well, I appreciate that, and I don't mean to put you on ice. I ask a lot of people that because all we hear is climate change, CO2. I heard a couple of you on the panel saying you're looking to change your vehicles to electric, even though we don't have the electric grid. And me as a farmer, I wouldn't be real happy about running out and replacing $300,000, $500,000, million pieces of equipment because someone wants it to be electric. The answer is 0.04%. Not 1%, not a half of a percent. It's 0.04%. It's gone up from 0.03 over the last couple decades. This is what we're being all contorted into doing, is this tiny change in CO2. If we get below 0.02, plant life starts dying off. So let me ask Mr. Boyd, are a lot of your vehicles Tier 4 already, or the vehicles that you know about in the industry?
Yes.
All right, so that's the cleanest burning diesel equipment you can get, right?
Yes.
All right, about Mr. Dreher, what do you think?
Yes.
Okay, so why would anybody be anxious to go out and change out all those vehicles that you've been upgrading? In my home state of California, CARB has eliminated lots of equipment. Trucks, you know, we're down at least 70,000 truckers. And all because they don't make a mandate for 2011 a newer vehicle. And so it's going to be harder to get things from the ports, all that. So